All right, Shalom. Yo, Hebrew Israelites, you come out here week in, week out to prophesy the downfall of America and the ushering in of the kingdom of heaven, okay? Which is going to be ruled by you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, okay? Which are the true Israelites according to the Bible, and also by us confusion of faith, Achaim, through our spirit, we go back to the 12 tribes of Israel, okay? But anyway, you know, which actually we got 15 minutes before this recorder turns off, so it might be a shorter lesson, so it's lucky about that, Achaim, but the point is, you know, actually, let's see. You know, we got to suffer hardships with the Lord, man, okay? We got to completely just lay our life down and suffer, man. All right, doesn't mean you're literally dying. You got to suffer along with the Lord, okay? We have to suffer what we're going through. All right, because remember, we were cursed, okay? We're a cursed people because we went off from the law, statute, and commandments, man. All right, we went off, so now we're suffering, okay? And that's a righteous thing, all right? Hey, bless you, how about you, Yeshua? Because, hey, the Lord's also going to redeem us from this punishment, all right? And this is almost over. This punishment is almost over, man. We've been here for hundreds of years. We were in hardcore slavery with a yoke of iron around our neck. Alright? Now, we're still in slavery today, don't get that wrong. We are in slavery. It's just not a physical slavery with whips and chains. But we are debt slaves, man. Alright? You are a slave to the system. Okay? The only way to be freed from this man fool system is by Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, man. Alright? But first you have to be an Israelite, okay? To be able to accept the Lord. This is Romans chapter 8 and 17. And if children, then here's a God, and join here's with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. 18. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory. Read that last part again. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Alright? So this suffering that we're going through, this cannot be compared to what we're going to receive. Okay? We are going to receive everlasting life. Alright? If we endure this man fool system. Okay? You have to endure this place to get the kingdom, right? You have to. There's no other way around it. You know, the affliction, there's no way to escape from our curses. We're a cursed people, man. Alright? But guess what? We deserve that punishment, man. We didn't at all. Alright? But we're suffering to this very day. Which really, I'm not going to get the curses on this video because that would probably take 20 minutes to read. I only got 15 minutes before this turns off. Right? But hey, if you read that, who's the only people that can apply to? You so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and also less confusion based Achaim, man. Right? But hey, he's still so much of a devil, he oppresses his own people too. Alright? Because he's the devil. That's why he says Job 9 and 24, the earth was given to the hands of the wicked. Alright? And who's the wicked? Esau, the so-called white man. Alright? And just because you're white does not mean you're an Edomite. Okay? Because we got certain brothers that are white and they're Israelites. It goes back for your spirit, okay? We got certain people that look like Edomites, but they're actually Israelites, all right? This is 2 Timothy chapter 2 and 3. Now therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahweh Shai, no man that were entangled himself with the flares of his life, that is to say, you have chosen him to be a soldier. Okay? Because the Lord has to choose you to come to his work. Okay? You can't, you know, you can't go to those so-called, I went to the Bible school to learn how to teach the Bible, so-called. Alright? Because you can't learn like that, man. They don't teach you. First of all, they don't even teach Americans in the Bible, man. So what the hell do they know? Alright? Hey, but first of all, they're the devil, okay? They're the devil, so of course, they're going to be doing that, man. Alright? That's how it is. Alright? Lucky, This is Isaiah chapter 29 and 13. Therefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near to me with their mouth and with their lips, they will honor me, but have removed. Now you know how it is, man. Curses are real. But have removed their heart far from me. And their fear towards, let me turn the page. Towards you. Block you. Let me grab this. Me is taught by the priest of men. Okay, that's a problem. Alright, you're going off the belief of men. You're not going off the Elabashi Yahshai. Alright, who the world calls Christ. You're going off the devil, okay? And who's the devil? The image of Christ, man. The white image. The Lord's a black man. All right, which I'll get that scripture in a bit after this. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do marvelous works among these people, even if there is work and wonder, for this wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of the prudent men shall be hid, right? Because that's what the scripture says. The Lord has made the wisdom of this world foolishness, man, okay? And who's the real wise people? We're the wise man, because the Lord reveals his secrets unto the servants of prophets, man. All right, which we understand. Hey, we're not trying to get rich, man. We're not trying to win a lot of money, okay, like you people are. All right, we're trying to follow Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, which is the way, the truth, and the life, man. All right, not Jesus, all right, which, you know, really, like I said, Yahshai, in a way, is Jesus, but he's a black man, and his name's not Jesus, okay? Woe to men that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord. The Lord and their works are in dark, and they say, who seeth us, and who knoweth us? Surely your turning things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay. For shall the work be of them that made it, he made me not? Or shall the thing framed say of him that framed it, he had no understanding? Okay? Let's talk about you devils, man. All right, because you push all these same philosophies among the people, man. Specifically the Israelites. All right. Let's see. I wanted to get Revelation chapter 1. This is Revelation chapter 1 and 14. His head and his hair white like wool, as white as snow. Eyes are in the flame of fire, and his feet like a defiant brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters, okay? But brass burned in a furnace turns black, okay? It doesn't turn, oh, we got one guy on the comment section, oh, it turns rainbow color. I mean, how stupid can you be? Or his loving Christian says, you know, oh, soon as you UFOs the real church. I mean, how stupid can you be? Hey, well, she's the devil, man, okay? And those so-called UFOs, the Lord's coming back in those, man, right? Because those are the chariots of Israel, okay? The Lord's coming back in those, man. All right, let me just check the time. All right, we got a few more minutes, all right? All right, because who you people call Jesus, which is real name Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, he's coming back, all right? He's coming back real soon, all right? Matter of fact, this is 2 Ezra, chapter 13, and 29. Behold, the day cometh, Lucky, the day is come, when the Most High will begin to deliver them that are upon the earth, and he shall come to the astonishment of them that dwell on the earth. Alright? Alright, so Yahweh is coming to the astonishment of those that dwell on the earth, man. Alright? That's exactly what that is talking about. Okay, he's going to come to the astonishment. Okay? Hey, nobody's looking for the Lord, man. They say, the guy 2,000 years ago, man. This scripture says 1,000 years to us is one day with the Lord. So really, the Lord died 2,000 days ago, man. Alright? Which is, you know, really, when you go deeper, the apostles that were with the Lord, the men that were with the Lord, when the Lord told them the signs of the end, they thought it was going to happen when, the empires went down back then. Alright? But no, those empires went down, and they were reincarnated back today, man. The Roman Empire's back today, right? America's the Roman Empire through the scriptures, man. And America's that Roman Empire, right? So that's what also describes as the beast who was not dead, right? Because when it fell, it was brought back to life once again, right? And that's why, like I said, that's why it's called the beast who was not dead, right? Because it's back, man. Matter of fact, I'm over here in Rome, right? Matter of fact, look at the government buildings, man. They go back to Rome, right? So there you go, right there, right? They go back to the Roman Empire, right? But anyway, I just want to do that lesson real quick. Right, I better get going. Alright? But anyway, I want to say, call a ball and call a box to the outside. It is true. That being said, she's under the ground.